Hi students, welcome to history class. Before starting lesson, I am asking some questions from previous class. Who pressed for the universalization of British education in India? Charles Grant. Who facilitated the expansion of British education in India? Warren Hastings. Who established Sanskrit College in Benares? Jonathan Duncan. What are the impact of British education on India? Indians could develop modernity, secularism, democratic attitudes and rationality along with nationalistic ideals. Second one, impetus received for local literature and language. Third one, periodicals started emerging. Next, new social and religious reformation movement started. Next, freedom struggles took place over the globe, influenced Indians. Last one, Indians could understand and appreciate rich tradition. Okay, these are all you studied in previous. Let's today's class, we may learn about constitutional development. How does Constitution of India come into force? And which are the laws implemented by British in India, and how does these laws help the evolution of constitution in India? Okay, so along with British administration, problems also started in India. In order to solve these problems, reformation in administration become important, and these reformations needed to fulfill the demands of the people. So British created different types of rules in the form of laws. So these laws helpful for evolution of constitution in India. Okay, so let's today's class, we may learn about these laws one by one. Okay, so along with British administration, British administration started in India. Okay, and problems also started. Okay, when British administration started in India, along with it, problems also started in India. To solve these problems, reformation. Okay, what is meant by reformation? Reformation means changes. Okay, reformation means what? Changes. Okay, changes in administration that become important. Okay, some changes made in administration. That is the best solution for problems that created in India. Okay, and these reformations need to fulfill the demands of people. Okay, or demands of Indians. Which are the reformations made by British that must fulfill the demands of Indians? Okay, Indians must satisfy, okay, with these reformations. That type of reformations needed in India. In this moment, British created different rules. They created different rules, okay, in the form of laws. Okay, they created different rules in the form of laws. So these laws become the base or foundation. Okay, foundation for evolution. Okay, evolution of constitution. Okay, in India. Okay, here British created different types of laws in the form of acts or
laws.
Okay, so these laws became the foundation or main base for evolution. Apo constitution in India. Evolution means beginning. Okay, all these laws helpful for the birth of constitution in India. Okay, by considering laws implemented by British in India, our constitution was framed by our national leaders. Clear this? Okay, now we may learn about these laws one by one. Laws implemented by British in India. Okay, which are the laws implemented by British in India? Okay, British implemented various laws. Okay, why? To reform administration system of India. Okay, so now we may study these laws one by one. Okay, first one, Regulating Act. Regulating Act of 1773. Okay, first act or act is also called law. Okay, Regulating Act of 1773. Okay, next, second one, Pitt's India Act. Pitt's India Act of 1792. This is the second act, Pitt's India Act. Okay. Third one, Charter Act. Charter Act of 1813. Okay. Next, Charter Act of 1833. Okay. Next, British Government Act of 1858 to 1947. Okay, next, Indian Government Act of 1858. Okay, next, Indian Council Act of 1861. Okay, next, 1892. Okay, next, 1909. Okay, clear this? First one, Regulating Act of 1773. Next, Pitt's India Act of 1792. Charter Act of 1813 and 1833. Okay, Charter Act of 1813 and 1833. Next, British Government Act of 1858. Then Indian Government Act of 1858. Next, Indian Council Act of 1861. Then Indian Council Act of 1892 and Indian Council Act of 1909. Okay, along with this, remaining two laws are there. Okay, first one, Government of India Act 1919. Okay, the next, Government of India Act of 1935. Okay, these are all the acts or laws implemented by British in India. Okay, so this Government of India Act, okay, this is the last act implemented by British. This act, okay, became the foundation of Indian Constitution. Okay, this act, Government of India Act 1935. Okay, this act became the base of evolution of Indian Constitution. Okay, our Constitution was created by the help of this act. Clear this? Okay, now we may learn about these acts one by one. Okay, these are all acts implemented by British in India. Okay, first one, Regulating Act 1773. Here, after the implementation of Diwani rights in 1765, the company officials misused the provision, and become rich in corrupt way. Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II gave Diwani rights to British in 1765. Can you remember this? Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II gave Diwani rights. Diwani right means authority to collect land tax or power to collect land tax. Mughal Emperor Shah Alam II offered Diwani rights. Diwani rights means power to collect land tax. To whom he gave this power? To British. In which year? 1765. Why he gave this power to British? Because in the Battle of Buxar, he was defeated by the hands of British. So he defeated and surrendered to English. In this moment, he gave Diwani rights to British in the year 1765. Here Diwani right, that is the authority to collect land taxes from the people. But what happened? Some of the company officials misused this facility. Some company officials of East India Company misused this opportunity. Shah Alam II gave Diwani rights to British. Diwani rights means power to collect land taxes. But some of the company officials, company workers, they misused this opportunity. And they become very rich. They earned a lot of profit and they become very rich in a corrupt way. By following the path of bribe or corruption. Here some of the company officials become a very rich. So here Edmund Burke. He was a member of East India Company. He was a member of or British Parliament. He was a member of British Parliament. He criticized corruption in East India Company. Here Edmund Burke, he was a member of British Parliament. He criticizing means insulted. Criticized corruption in East India Company. Here company officials of East India Company making money, without effort by following the path of bribe or corruption, they are getting more money. They become very rich. In this way, member of British Parliament, Edmund Burke, he started to criticize, to East India Company. And he termed this as criminal tax. He termed this, event is called criminal tax. So what is criminal tax? Your tax received by British government from East India Company. Okay, he called this tax as criminal tax. Okay, why? Because company officials, they followed the path of bribe or corruption and they become very rich and they made money. Later they gave that money to British government. Okay, they gave that money to British government. But Edmund Burke, okay, he was a very sincere person. He called this is not a tax, but this is a criminal tax. Okay, in this way he criticized to British government. Okay, why does he criticized in this way? There is one reason is there. Because here British government remained silent. Okay, to know the corruption in East India Company. Really, British government knew company officials were engaged in a corruption, but also it remained silent. So he criticized in this way. Okay, here British government remained silent to know the corruption in a East India Company. Okay, already British government know company officials of East India Company engaged in a corruption, but also it remained silent. Okay, so Edmund Burke, okay, he termed this is not a tax, but this is a criminal tax. Okay, clear this. Okay, so to control this, some of the company officials, okay, they made more money and they become super rich, but people of England, they got fear. Okay, why? Because these rich people can upset the political fabric of the country. Okay, but here company officials become super rich, they become very rich. Okay, but people of England got fear. Okay, they were rich, they are very rich, so they can disturb the political situation of a country. Why they got fear? Because they can upset or disturb the political situation of the country. Okay, so to control misuse of authority, Regulating Act was passed in the year 1773. Okay, in this way Regulating Act come into force. Okay, to control the misadministration of British. Okay, Government of England implemented which act? Regulating Act. Clear all of you? Okay. Next. Before the implementation of Regulating Act, there were three presidencies under the control of British. One Bengal, Madras and Calcutta. Okay. before the implementation of Regulating Act, three presidencies were ruled by British. Okay, three presidencies were under the control of British. Which are those? First one, Bombay Presidency. Next one, Bengal Presidency. Third one, Madras Presidency. Okay, and these presidencies were under the control of British. Okay, and these three presidencies were independent presidencies. Okay, these three presidencies were independent. Okay, these three presidencies were not under the control of any other presidencies, or it was not under the control of others. Okay, they are taking decision. Okay, they are giving suggestion, everything openly and independently. Okay, without the interference of others. Okay, so these three presidencies were independent when before the implementation of a regulating act. So what happened after the implementation of a regulating act? Okay, we may study this one by one. First one, Bengal presidency gained control over other two presidencies. Three presidencies are there. First one, Bengal. Second one, Bombay. Third one, Madras. Clear this? Here what happened? What are the features of regulating act? Okay, before the implementation of regulating act, three presidencies are there. One, Bombay, Bengal and Madras. Okay, and they were independent. They were not under the control of any other people, or they are taking independent decisions. Okay, and they are taking decisions independently, openly, and they are giving suggestions. They are acting according to their own wish. Okay, they were not under the control of anyone. Okay, but later what happened? After the implementation of regulating act, what happened? Okay, first one, Bengal presidency gained control over other two presidencies. Okay, after the implementation of regulating act, what happened? Bengal presidency gained control over other two presidencies. Okay, these two presidencies came under the control of Bengal. Okay, Bengal took control of other two presidencies. Okay, clear this? Next, governor of Bengal became the Governor General of three presidencies. Okay, who became the Governor General of three presidencies? Governor of Bengal. Okay, Governor of Bengal became the Governor General of three presidencies also. In this moment, Warren Hastings. Okay, Warren Hastings. He was the Governor General of three presidencies. He became the Governor General of three presidencies. Okay, third one. Governor General was authorized to direct control and supervise three presidencies. Okay, your governor, you got full power. What is this power? Okay, to giving direction to all these three presidencies. Not only this, he controlled all these three presidencies. Okay, these three presidencies were controlled by Governor General of Bengal. Okay, not only this, he supervised the work of these three presidencies. Okay, your Governor General, he examined the work of all these presidencies. Next point, Bombay or Madras presidencies could not declare war or could not enter agreement with each other without the approval of Governor General or directors of East India Company. Okay, next feature of regulating act, Bombay and Madras presidencies could not declare war or enter agreements without the approval of Governor General of Bengal. Clear this? Bombay and Madras presidencies could not declare war on others. If they want to declare war on others, then they must take the permission of Governor General of Bengal. Okay, or they must take the permission of directors. Okay, directors of East India Company. Clear this? Bombay and Madras presidencies could not declare war on others without the permission of Governor General of Bengal. Okay, not only this, Bombay and Madras presidencies could not enter agreements. Okay, they could not enter peace agreements. Okay, they could not enter friendship agreement with others without the permission of Governor General of Bengal. If they want to develop a good friendship agreement with others, then they must ask the permission of Governor General of Bengal or directors of East India Company. Only during the emergencies, okay, these presidencies add power to exercise their power. But in other moment, they have no power, okay, to act according to their own wish. Okay, next. According to this act, Supreme Court of Judicature was established in Calcutta. Okay, according to this act, Supreme Court of Judicature established in India, and it includes one chief judge and the remaining three other judges. Okay, after the implementation of regulating act, okay, Supreme Court of Judicature, okay, established in India. Okay, one Supreme Court after the implementation of regulating act, Supreme Court of Judicature or Supreme Court was established in India. Okay, and so this includes one chief judge, okay, one main judge, and remaining three other judges. Clear this? Totally regulating act implemented to control misadministration in East India Company. Okay, when British got Diwani rights in 1765, then company officials misused that opportunity for their benefit and they become super rich. So Edmund Burke, he was a member of British Parliament, he criticized corruption in East India Company. Why? Because the British government already know the fact East India Company engaged in corruption, but also it remained silent. So he called this type of tax as criminal tax. Okay, tax received from the British government, okay, from East India Company, that is called criminal tax. Okay, totally to control all these activities of East India Company, regulating act was implemented. What are the features of regulating act? You already studied. Here Bengal presidency gained control over other two presidencies. Governor of Bengal became the governor general of three presidencies. So governor general was authority to direct control and supervise other two presidencies. Okay, then here Madras and Bombay presidencies could not declare war or enter agreement without permission of Governor General of Bengal or directors of East India Company. Last one, according to this act, Supreme Court of Judicature established in Calcutta. Okay, it includes one main judge and remaining three other judges. Okay, so in this class you studied what are the features of a regulating act. Okay, so tomorrow class we may study about remaining important laws implemented by British in India. Okay, so what are the features of regulating act of 1773? This is very important 3-mark question for exam. So study